Non-news in a battle. They're down 65-57 with 4:03 left here in the game. And timeout as Coach Schaefer is trying to get some momentum back on his side. The Eagles with a couple of wide open three-pointers there, Steve. Not a whole lot the Mountaineers could do with that. And they just got to keep plugging away here. Well, the Eagles are playing loose basketball. They're scoring a lot of points. The Mountaineers are tied. They've only scored 12 points in the second half. Plus, the Eagles have outscored 36-12 in the second half. To totally overcome the 16-point deficit, try and extend the lead by 8. And they've got the basketball. Currently, the Mountaineers are sitting at 4-26 and 15.4% shooting on the floor. And Northern New Mexico was 14-26 for 53%, almost 54% shooting. That's Charlie Eagles right there. Here's the inbound. Richardson bringing up the floor, up by 8. Mountaineers have Roberts and Harding up front. Problem, Subart and Porter are the 5. Another 3-pointer. And this one's good again by Jose Rodriguez. He's got 5. That extends the lead to 11. Mountaineers miss a shot on the other end. Goes with the rebound. Oh. And now a little scrum down there. Oh. It's both teams pushing each other around. We're going to have some fouls called here. And I'll bet we have an ejection or two before this is all over. Zach got out of hand. Frustration by the Mountaineers. Aggressive basketball by the Eagles. We're going to have a little discussion on the floor as we've got a timeout on the floor. Subart kind of started that, got a little carried away, and then it escalated from there. Yeah, again, it was an aggressive play by the Eagles that dominated the second half here. Jack, as a matter of fact, they're with 3 rebounds now. Mountaineers had a significant lead early. Still have a lead 44-37, but the Eagles have come back hard. Yeah, well, we can leave it here at Harvard. We can send it back and hear from a sponsor too. The officials are going to be there for a while. We'll stay right here for a little bit and see what goes on. I'm not going to mention any names, Chuck, but there were several players on both teams that went in there, and, you know, basketball fights aren't all that much, but there were attempted fists thrown down there by officials. Don't want the teams back on the floor, and they're still looking at the monitor. They don't even want anybody to check in right now. Wilcox has been trying to get the game. I'm pretty sure Harding's going to come out, regardless of the call. So, a fight trying to break out in the middle of a basketball game. Mountaineers are feeling the pressure now. 3:37 left. You got plenty of time. You're down by 11. Northern New Mexico should have the ball. It depends on who is still on the floor after this discussion is had. I'm betting, Chuck, we're going to see probably a couple of ejections. And there may be additional fouls called on that little skirmish flag under the western bucket. Apparently they're down there with the bookkeeper, if you will. I'm not sure what the discussion is there, so we'll... Now we have, looks like Coach Allen.
Cool, okay.
Selected down there.
Yeah, it's Coach Allen down there running the scoreboard. Diligently, if you will.
And now the
referees are going to go to the monitor and kind of sort some things out, figure out who did what here. But I got to tell you, the people that are most disadvantaged under these circumstances, Chuck, are the officials. When you got that much physical activity going on either, there's no way they can catch it all. And, Chuck, they should not let the other New Mexico coach come over there to monitor like that. Now they rotate the third official on it, and all three officials will take a hard look at what they saw here, and there'll be a sort out. You know, they sent the Western players back to the Magic coach, and they're letting the Northern New Mexico coach sit there and look over their shoulder. He's about 5-6 feet away, on the monitor. He didn't go back to the bench and leave the officials alone. Now we're going to have a little conference between the official, the head official, and the two head coaches. Point to the Western players first. Doesn't necessarily mean anything. Now to the Eagles. I'll be surprised if everybody finishes this game.
I need to have a mic down there.
Yeah. Of course, the worst part about this is it extends the game unnecessarily, right? No bounds lost for both teams. That's not necessarily bad for Western. They haven't had the momentum the entire second half. 68-57 to score. Northern New Mexico had the basketball. Western had scored 12 points in the second half. Western New Mexico has scored 39 points. And that tells you what led to the frustration. So, Chuck, watch and see who goes to the locker room there. Harding and Subart are going. For the Mountaineers, they're both gone. And it looks like Dion and Solomon and number three, Martinez, and Dion. So the Mountaineers are going to lose two guys that are pretty key to their offense. Well, the Western lost their two top scorers, Subart and Harding, right? The Eagles lost three of their ball players, including Solomon, who's been a key player all night long. And we'll finish out the last 3 minutes and 37 seconds with a little different configuration. On the floor, Erland will go for the Mountaineers along with Roberts, Willis, Porter, and Wilcox. For the Eagles, they're going to go with Rodriguez, Simmons, and free throws are being shot by the Eagles. Weavers at the free throw line. His first shot is up and no good. And the second shot is up and in. So Weaver gets one of two, and that'll extend the lead to 12, 69 to 57. So the technical foul was called against the Mountaineers. We get one of, Northern New Mexico gets one of two free throws and the basketball. Here's the inbound. Richards will bring it across, up by 12, 3:30 left. We'll go across court to Rodriguez. Rodriguez shot up and good. That's a three-pointer. That'll run the lead to 15. Roberts to Willis. Now to Porter for the Mountaineers. Back to Willis. Willis in the paint. We'll pick it out to Roberts in the corner. He'll put out the three, and he'll hit the three. So Roberts with his second bucket of the second half. 12-point ball game. 2:58 left. Roberts will pick up Richards, full court, knocked the ball away, he's got it, he'll call timeout, and the Mountaineers
will get that possession. Great play by Roberts to pick the pocket there on Richards. We're going to take